闘技をやりながらテレビに出る機会が何度かあって、私のファッションであったりその生活をする、まあ、雑誌のモデルをさせてもらったりっていうところで格闘技と並行にいろんなメディアに出るようになりました。すごく緊張しましたね。楽しかったですけどね。まあ、ちょうど子供が生まれて2年ぐらい、2歳、3歳ぐらいの時にそういうリアリティショーがあるということで、初めは断ったんですが、どうしても出てほしいということでオファーをいただきました。まあ、家族の生活を皆さんに見せるということでプライベートがなくなると思って嫌だったんですよね。あまり私が子供の写真を撮ったりビデオを撮ったりすることがなかったんですよね。番組を通してそれがフィルムとして残るのでいい思い出になるんではないかなと思ってオファーを受けました。私一人の撮影であれば全く自分の都合でいろいろ動けるんですが、子供と一緒ということでやはり子供に合わせないといけないというところですごくやはり撮影として大変でした。1回目の放送が出ても爆発したので正直びっくりしました。一度、私と娘と2人で日本から韓国に入った時に空港で取材陣が待ってたんですけれども、その時のカメラの台数が多分100台以上あったと思うんですよ。それを見た時にものすごいことになってるなと思いました。正直驚いたのがまず一つと、その次にすぐにやはり今言ったように娘がすごく怖がって僕から離れなかったんですよね。それが逆に彼女のトラウマになってしまって、空港の韓国の空港を出る時には必ず抱っこしてくれって一時期続いたんですよ。もしかしたらカメラがいるんじゃないかって言ってストレスで、余計に彼女をプロテクトしなくてはいけないなと思いました。やはり撮影の日がもう必ず決まっていて、その日はもう2日3日は必ず撮られるので、そういう撮影とトレーニングと両立させるっていうのはすごく大変なんですけれども、逆に撮影をする時にリラックスをしてオフにして、そこで娘から元気をもらってオンでトレーニングをするっていう切り替えをしてました。
Turned on by Amir Khan in the final 45 seconds was phenomenal. Switch step roundhouse kick to open up for the Singaporean in the black trunks.
Expect Amir Khan to shift into a different gear in this round. He's got the conditioning. Song Jong Lee looks a little bit fatigued, looks a little bit tired. Khan looks very relaxed, very fresh.
Could we see a contender here for the Go Daddy knockout of the night? Khan still peppering with the jab, threading it well. Changes angles, beautiful dipping left hand, hoping for the liver of the Korean. Then goes back upstairs. Jab two kangaroo from Amir Khan.
Let's see Khan go up high with the right kick. You can see Sung Jong Lee starting to drop his hands a little bit, especially in some of these wild exchanges.
The lead hand of Amir Khan tonight has been a thing of beauty. Trucking elbow. The knees now from the Muay Thai clinch. Sung Jong Lee drops down, hoping that Khan will follow him. And Khan doesn't want any piece of that.
Sung Jong Lee's putting himself in a bad position in a lot of these, like, sort of sacrifice, pulling guard type maneuvers that he's doing. Oh, nice left hook there from Sung Jong Lee. And again, he pulls guard again, but now Khan's a little bit slippery, so he slid right off.
Don't forget, Amir Khan brought three Japanese wrestlers to Singapore to prepare for the takedown defense. And he's showing it well at the moment. The training has paid off. An extensive count for Amir Khan. But guts and intestinal fortitude here from Sung Jong Lee of South Korea.
Yeah, Michael, but he brought in takedown wrestlers, people that were trying to push him up against the cage and take him down. Sung Jong Lee is attempting some very interesting little scissor takedown there into a leg lock. He's got that good grip on that heel. Look at Khan trying to run away. Oh, chooses to sit back down.
Reverse hammer fist there from Amir Khan.
Possible calf slicer here on that right leg of Khan. This is a painful position to be in right now.
All tied up like a demented game of Twister. Khan just glances over to his corner. What are they telling Khan to do here, man?
Look at that leg. Yeah, he's like, all right, just trying to sit up out of this position. There's a full calf slicer on the right leg of Amir Khan. Very painful move. He's got to try to get his hips away and slide out. Song Jong Lee is crafty on the ground, man. Some of these submission attempts, that scissor takedown, woo, impressive. Now he's going after the heel hook. It looks like it's a straight leg lock.
Leg locks are the specialty of Song Jong Lee.
Achilles lock there, puts a lot of pressure on that Achilles there, right below the calf muscle.
Amethyst strikes, elbows from top position, still the legs tied up of Amir Khan. 2 minutes remaining here in the second round. You know that Khan wants to find a way back to his feet, Mitch.
You can see Song Jong Lee's got the legs triangle. Now he's going for a cross body Ashigarami, maybe from that position. That's what it looks like. Trying to extend the legs there. Going after the, yep, that's where he's going after. Going after the heel hook on that side.
1 minute 40 now. Still Song Jong Lee playing the leg lock game. Looking for the Achilles, looking for the heel, looking for the knee.
Look at it. That's a heel hook right there. Look at Khan trying to roll. He's trying to get his leg out. But now you would almost think that Benario was naturally a wrestler and a grappler. Big head kick there, just barely misses Benario, slid underneath it. And again, he goes right in for the takedown. This is definitely something that we're not used to seeing. Benario consistently shooting for takedowns and not throwing those heavy hands and kick strikes.
A lot of Filipinos who get into the fight game started off just messing around with something that I think they call buton, which is a form of wrestling. And that is where Benario started. Kevin Beling on as well very much had that kind of a background before being schooled in wushu and transforming their activities to a striking-based martial art.
Here he is in the half guard of Jartim. So he's gonna wanna try to pop that leg out. He's got the right leg inside the half guard of Jartim, so he's gonna wanna try to slide that knee out, pass into side control. Jartim's doing the right thing by turning onto his side so he's not lying flat onto his back. Good reversal by Jartim to end up on top.
It's a great effort from the Czech fighter.
Benario just stands right back up. Jartim up against the cage.
That's the strength of Benario. Oh, left hand! Knocks him flat on his back, and with one punch, Benario extends his winning streak to four.
Ready, go!
And they're all behind one shin, Shannon Wirajai. Wirajai in southpaw stance, the tall, gangly beanpole Indian in orthodox stance. Shannon Wirajai said he did more sparring in training in this camp than ever before.
Oh, the big kibosh! The big kibosh! The big kibosh! The big kibosh! It's good night, Irene!
5 3-minute rounds. We've had one of them. Potentially 12 more minutes to come, and judges will score this round by round using the 10-point mark system. Exchange of kicks early in this round, and the pace has increased as compared with the first 3 minutes. Sam A has really stepped things up.
And Sam A going back to the low kicks, chopping on the long legs of Roland.
He got a bit of a surprise towards the end of that round, didn't he? And maybe that just told him that he needs to just move things up a level. It's a marathon, not a sprint. 5 rounds here, and Sam A knows that better than anybody.
Roland not phased at all. By Sammy's throwing back strikes of his own.
Just getting caught on the top of the head, stumbling back into the wall of the circle. What a prospect facing Sammy, gonna head out. He just cannot hide. The to catch up with you.
Then look for spinning elbow.
Twice. Gianni, anyway, he wasn't far off, but Sami.
Great left! Great left by Sami!
Sent that left in towards the chin. It doesn't look to me as if Roland's getting up. He's on his back, arms to the side. We're at the count of nine, and it's over. With 100 seconds left in the second round, and I must say, that was an absolute exhibition.
Second round of three on the one fantasy game. The fans leaning in the direction of Janet's side by 59% for the win tonight over Ekaterina Vandereva. This one scored on a 10-point must system. So the winner of the round gets 10 points. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. And your score, folks, wherever you're watching live in over 140 countries around the world, from TNT in the USA to Skynet in Myanmar, Toggle in Singapore, Star Sports Select in India, all over the world. For one century, the largest martial arts show ever. It's not just boring with that lead hand to set the right hand or the right roundhouse kick. It's the right roundhouse kick to the lead leg of Vandereva. Vandereva skipped forward, didn't commit, however. Looks for the inside leg, it takes one to the outside leg, around that sciatic nerve there, does Janet. Vandereva, a graduate of Belarusian State University, a degree in tourism management. Had to use it though in the last 6 years, applying her trade as a professional Muay Thai combatant around the world at the very highest level. IFMA 2009 gold medalist, 2010 WKN world champion.
Beautiful combination there thrown by Janet. You can see a little bit of damage on the left side of her ear there. I think she got clipped by Vandereva. She was throwing that nice exchange.
Nice knee on the inside off the left leg here from Janet Todd. They tango, center of the circle. Referee Onari breaks them.
Go!
K1 fans may recognize referee Onari from back in the illustrious K1 days. He was a mainstay on what was then the biggest kickboxing stage in the world. Now, of course, it is one super series. And we are seeing a very high-level Muay Thai contest at the moment. Hook to leg kicks there from Vandereva.
Time just to be looks a little bit tighter in her technique. She's able to land shots right up the middle, just like that. Beautiful jab to a body shot.
There's a very interesting technique that.
This is Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.